I'm going to talk about AI, artificial intelligence. Machines that learn, do they make sense or do they have sense? I work in the Department of Computer Science, but more and more I feel like I'm not actually working with computers, but with something kind of beyond that, something where the computer is just a vessel for a thing. And maybe even so that my work is more about kind of human-like things. Artificial intelligence, what is that? Well, we humans and animals, we have what we call real intelligence. While if a machine does something that requires intelligence, then we say that the machine has artificial intelligence. Machine learning and AI, well, machine learning is kind of a subfield of AI. And while AI asks big questions like, can machines think? Are machines really intelligent? Or do they have a soul? Machine learning takes a step back, a more pragmatic, practice-oriented approach. In machine learning, we ask questions like, can machines do things that we humans can do? What is that? Well, learn from past experiences, understand inputs, or predict the future based on past observations. Machine learning has come a long way, and especially in the past, say, 10, 15 years, there's been a clear shift. There's been some breakthroughs in modeling natural data, natural chaotic data. And by chaotic, I actually mean quite ordinary. The kind of data that we need to digest all the time. You sit there, you listen to me, yeah, there's a feed of images coming in through your eyes, you're listening to me with your ears, you're interpreting what's happening. That's all quite natural to us, because evolution has drafted our senses and our brain to kind of cope with the chaos. This is not easy for machines. And the breakthroughs now in the past 10, 15 years have been in actually handling this type of natural chaotic data. And here, the models are basically their functions that can take in natural data such as images, natural text, sounds, and so on, and process that in kind of a nonlinear fashion into something else that might be complicated, like other images, text, or simple decisions like yes, no. And there's been a lot of advances in this space, and we can actually already do quite incredible things. I guess you're all familiar with these AI chatbots that you can interact with through natural language, and they can provide you with outputs then based on your inputs. The same kind of applies to any problem domains where we have a lot of data that we can use for training models. Say, for example, the internet is full of images. So and here there's a generative image model that has seen a lot of images. And I'm asking the model here to generate kind of a new data point. A data point, an image of a painting in the style of the Finnish master Albert Ehrenfeldt, of an old man checking his smartphone. Well, in the time of Albert Ehrenfeldt, there were old men, but no smartphones. But the model has seen oil paintings, works by Edelfelt, smartphones, and all these things. So the concepts are clear for the model. And now it's kind of bringing together these concepts and generates a new data point that is then mapped into an image. We can also do other amazing things. I mentioned that one thing that these AIs we strive for there is understanding. And we humans, we are very good at understanding, like generalizing from what we have seen and learned to new things. And this particular input image was not part of the training data set for this machine learning model that I'm using here. And we humans, we are good. We look at the image, and at least I can see a human being holding a balloon. There's the sun, there's stars, and so on. Even though they are quite abstract looking. And I'm feeding this input into a machine learning model and asking it to generate a new image as if it would be drawn by a slightly older artist. And I get this, where the same concepts are present, so clearly some sort of understanding happened. And I can repeat this process as if it would be drawn by an even older artist. And now the same concepts are there. There's a human being, the balloon, the stars, the sun. So clearly, there's some sense to this. I still claim that we aren't quite there. This is one of my favorite generated images. It's a bit dated. It's by a quite early image generative model. And I generated it for a talk where old meets new, like horse meets electric car. And only later I noticed that the horse actually has 5 legs. And now you would think, if these models are so smart and they understand and so on, generalize, that out of the hundreds of millions of images that were used for training the model would have learned that animals usually have an even number of legs. This is a slightly newer model. This is from an AI product. And I'm asking it here to generate an empty room with absolutely no elephant in it. Who would have an elephant in a room? And if you look closely at the image, there's just a tiny elephant there. And this also hints at that, well, these models don't quite make sense in the same way as we humans. Well, I already showed an example from ChatGPT, and here I'm simply asking the generative model to count the numbers of letters K in a sentence. And it comes up with a plausible sounding, but a completely incorrect answer. If we then think of, our national languages. So for example, here, I'm asking another generative AI chatbot. This is Gemini by Google. If mommy and daddy can get married? And the answer is no. Weird. Or, this is me Googling a couple of weeks ago. I'm asking Google that who is the father of the spouse of the president of Finland. It comes up with some complete nonsense. And this is the flagship product of Google. So we aren't quite there yet. Okay, I'm not maintaining these big models, so what's my role in all of this? I would say that, I, together with my research group, we build building blocks. So we aren't building those big Lego models. We are designing the blocks that are used for building them. So fundamental research delivers the blocks. And by blocks, I mean, model components, how to build these AI models, how to make those model components include inductive biases and prior information, how to train these models, training algorithms, principles that help training things in more data efficient manners. And then methods to use for inferring things with the help of these models. How to improve on robustness and data efficiency, for example. And I think that one thing that these models that we have today are lacking is something that each and every one of us has. And that is common sense. And with common sense, sort of, I link that with actually us knowing what we don't know about. And these models typically, they don't have that. So I want to build models that know what they don't know. This is also important for other things. Some people say that we humans, our brains have two sides. There's kind of the artistic side that is good at coming up with things. And then there's the kind of structured engineering mindset that is good at systematic things. So I claim that actually to have AI models that work well, we need to have these both sides. And if you think then like, well, this is kind of universal. So you need to have this creative problem solving boldness and then the structure side that, for example, for counting the letters, we then systematically go through and check how many letters K there are in a sentence. And we could also claim that this is kind of a bit like we have at Aalto. We have the artistic side and the engineering side, and then business is binding it all together. This is also important then for the future, because for long, AI models were used for analyzing things, classifying things and predicting. Now we moved into AIs that generate, are good with natural data and can generate new things. And we are moving towards AIs that act, where actually creative problem solving is key. Well, do we actually make sense of these machines that learn? I would say that it's actually quite easy to take your Lego model, look at one block in the model, open up the block and look what's inside. So it's easy to understand how these models work. But there are still aspects that are mysteries to us. And I claim that it's hard to understand why they work. And for that, we need research. And that's driving me. Thank you.